Hello everyone, and welcome to my most anticipated figure of the year. Personally, my favorite figure of the year, despite getting Serpentor and all these other great figures, it's just Dusty is my favorite character of all time. So there's a lot of bias in that, and I think that they did a good job with the figure here. Close look at the box art. Dusty would have been nice to have his full name here, but according to people on the internet, there's different what would you call it, licensing issues and whatnot. But here we have a great shot of Dusty, very stern look. Here we have him in a sort of sandstorm, and then further up he is sort of behind the wall taking cover. He's number 49 in the series. He has different abilities. I assume he's good in many languages. Here's the back of the art. I don't think they've added any of the new characters onto here. It's kind of sad to see. Not much more at the bottom or at the top. We get the number and star. But yeah, very nice box art. And I guess I can do a quick comparison to another one. It's not a vintage or anything, but we have the G.I.JOE Dusty here. I forgot from which series this was from, but yeah, there he is. Very new style packaging. He has a file card on here. So we can read this to get a little bit more of knowledge on Dusty himself. We also have this other file card, the original. So maybe this one summarizes it down. Ronald W. Tadler, for those who don't know, this is a Easter egg of the original G.I.JOE character designer. His name was Ron Rudat, so here they just extended Ronald, they added the W, and they flipped his last name to be Tatter. So if you flip it over, it goes to Rudat. So it's a very nice Easter egg. The creator, or the original G.I.JOE designer, was from Las Vegas, Nevada, and so I get he lived in the desert area, so that is why he inspired Dusty off of that experience. Even giving his birthplace here, Las Vegas, Nevada. You can see he has military special infantry, and his second specialty is refrigeration and air conditioning. I think camera's picking up on Zaran in the back. Refrigeration and air conditioning. Let's see. Dusty loves the desert. It is clean, pure, and unforgiving, unlike Vegas, which is always willing to give you a second chance. Dusty was working as a refrigerator repairman and studying desert ecology at night when his pre-enlistment application for the G.I.JOE team was approved. He took basic at Fort Bliss, Texas. Hey, that's Fort Bliss. Wow, okay, I haven't read this very thoroughly, but that's cool. And loved every minute of it. He's qualified expert for M16s, M14s, M1911A1 pistol, and M60s. A little quote down here, it's not enough nowadays to have a rapid reaction force responsive instantaneously to explosive situations in far-flung corners of a globe. That force must be capable of surviving in a diverse array of hostile environments to accomplish its objectives. If that means having one expert for every type of environment on every team to take on survival responsibilities on that terrain, then so be it. So there's the file card. And now we know more about Dusty. So, let me set up some things here and there, and then we'll move on with the review. So when I say Dusty is my favorite, I mean he is my favorite. I have different versions of him throughout the past years. You know, we have this guy over here who we saw in the blister package. So yeah, I bought an extra one to have out in hand. He didn't come with his extra head though. But yeah, I like this sort of head sculpt. We have a Spy Troops. Yes, this is Spy Troops era. As you can see there, he sort of stuck with his original look for the most part throughout these different variations. He was very cool because he came with the sand racer on the back there. So very nice vehicle to have. So Hasbro, if you're up to it, you know, Haslab on this, or somehow make it that it's not so big, but, you know, resembles the old sand racer here. But we'll be taking that out of the frame just because it takes up a lot of space. Gives us more space for the stand and Dusty here. We then have, I believe, version 3. I think this is... Yeah, I believe this is version 3, because version 2 would be Tiger Force. So, you know, I'm also excited to see if they ever make a Tiger Force Dusty. We have the mold and the different parts now for Dusty. It's a simple repaint. Hasbro, make it happen. I'll buy it. So, yeah, there's these two guys. And then, of course, we have the original Dusty himself here. So, you know, very copy and pasted look here. I don't mind it. I love this. You know, even down to the backpack, which we'll get, I guess, right away into accessories here. We'll move all these other tiny guys out of the way to make room for stuff. We have the FAMAS here. I mean, we'll do the down angle here. There we go. Remove all his accessories, which a lot of people are saying he doesn't come with a lot of accessories. I understand, but that doesn't bother me too much. At this point, I've gotten a lot of different or duplicates of other characters. I'm able to remove accessories from them and maybe put them on him. But here's the accessories for the original vintage Dusty, the famous FAMAS. That I don't have the bipod yet for, and his backpack here, which the new classified doesn't really follow the vintage one, but we do have the two canteens here, and we see those two canteens here as well. The new classified has all these other pouches, and I guess a bigger pouch at the top. Probably do the zoom in, because there's a lot of neat details here. Very well textured and all that stuff, as we've seen with every other classified. We have the FAMAS, very similar. I mean, of course, this is old, so, you know, can't really get all that detail in, but with this new one, yeah, you even get a grip there, and the bipod there shifts, and put it up there. I believe it's also removable. I don't want to damage my figures. Yep, it's removable if you try hard enough. But, oh, how easy is it to get it back in? I think, there it goes, it clicks in. Yeah, and it has a removable mag, which is very tough on mine. And Dusty just fell over. Yeah, removable mag as well. So, very nice rifle to have. Let's see, we took a look at the weapon, vintage, and all that stuff. We have two pairs of goggles with silver paint on them, which is nice. People were already complaining that we should have gotten the green lenses. I'm fine with these. If we get a Tiger Force, maybe then we'll get the green lenses. But we also get these ones that go on top of his helmet. So these are for him to wear or to just place over his head without the helmet. And these go on the helmet as shown right now. And the helmet itself is removable. No cloth. That is very disappointing, but that is fine with me. I do have a gridirons equipment upgrade kind of thing. But yeah, this one's nice. It's sculpted very well all throughout. Get the nice camo and then a whole bunch of sculpting inside. Straps nicely painted and all that stuff. Very nice. And then we have a knife, painted silver blade. You know, the black kind of leaks into the silver up here, but that's fine. It's a minor thing. This does not come with Dusty, but just to demonstrate those firing effects from the Viper Pack, fit I forget what this part of the weapon is, but yeah, it fits on the gun hole. So yeah, that being said, we'll take a closer look at Dusty himself. Alright, so going through articulation, it's very basic. So, you know, what we've known, arms go up that much, upper bicep swivel, butterfly joints, double elbows, this hinge goes side to side, and this one goes up and down. He has a crunch and back, and then a rocker at the bottom. So everything together can look, he can go down pretty far. He can go kick pretty well. Upper thigh cut here. Double jointed knees. Boot swivel. Foot goes back, forward, and ankle pivot. One thing with mine, this joint here, there seemed to be extra plastic, as you can see there. I kind of had to cut it away, but it's still very tight, and it's stressing the plastic in there, but I don't think it's something that is gonna ultimately break the figure. I don't know. I mean, if it does, then I'm happy to buy another one. I really don't care. It's Dusty. So then he looks up about that much, you know, dumbbell joints and all that stuff. And he looks down. He has great head movement. His sculpt is the same they used for Stalker, which honestly is kind of I'm not too upset they used Stalker's body. The only thing I've found different is his shirt. I believe it's a new shirt. This skirt piece is also new, and the vest here. But the shirt may just be a retool of previous shirts we've had, or shirt torsos. But this one, the undershirt here, has very like sharp turn in there. I don't know how well that you can see that, but I didn't see that in any other gel, so that's a new sort of undershirt piece. And then I think the rest is just sort of retooled, just because I didn't see any other shirt or torso with the same sort of folds and all that stuff. The detailing on this guy is amazing. We have Tatter, his last name, with the American flag at the top, G.I. Joe at the side. We have this sort of little green, what's it called, a hose, and it goes through here. I don't know how well that's going to pick up, but it goes through here, and you obviously can't see it, but it's sort of sculpted in there. It goes through, and then it exits out of here, and it goes into the hole over here, which is supposed to resemble a hose for water. So put in his backpack, he has his water container in there, and now he can stay hydrated while he is out in the desert. People complained about the helmet here, is that it wouldn't stay in place, and people are placing this backwards and then placing the helmet on top to make it stay in place. For me though, I haven't had much of an issue with that personally. But yeah, that's just me. But yeah, I mean, I think that's everything mostly we can look at. You know, we've seen the sculpt before. His hands are very well painted. His head, people were saying, is a direct retool of Duke. But I don't think they can get away with that. Each character is unique in their own way, and you know, Hasbro team has to make new sculpts for about every new character they release. But yeah, I do see the sort of, I guess, likeness to Duke, but yeah, they can't get away with reusing the same head sculpts. One thing that does throw me off is that he is sort of blondish rather than a redhead. Just because version 3 here, as you can see, he has red hair, and I think it's just been inconsistent throughout the years. You know, he's a redhead and then a blonde, but that doesn't really bother me too much. But yeah, let me get the Gridiron Studios equipment, and then we'll try and see what we can do with that. Alright everyone, so here I have the Gridiron Studios pack, and ooh, we have a whole bunch of goodies here, and one of the mags stuck there. So right off the bat, I don't think I'll be using this, simply because this isn't a peg system. This is more of it sticks onto the figure, and I don't want to do that. I also don't know how long that will last, and like what kind of residue it'll leave. But it's a neat pack. You know, you have a walkie-talkie here. It slips out, you can take it out. And then he also has a knife, which is a bit too big. I like his small knife he came with. That's fine with me. He has a canteen as well. Also a sort of tape system, so I'm not gonna be using that. Maybe with some other character, I'll put it on them. But one thing that's nice is the sort of ghillie suit they gave us. And here's the helmet and the cloth piece. I'm not sure how to do this whole cloth piece thing. So I don't know, we'll give it a shot here. Just cause, let's see. Well, that kind of works. Maybe folding the cloth in different ways so that it doesn't stick out like that. But you know, from this angle, it kind of looks kind of nice. It is very kind of stiff, so maybe without the backpack, you can smooth it in out. Or I can try again and get it in a better position that isn't so awkward. Let's try it this way. Okay, maybe that works a bit better. Not sure. I mean, if you get the equipment yourself, you can do it whichever way you want, but it doesn't look half bad. I don't think the sort of color matches with the torso. Maybe on camera it does, but from my eye, it doesn't really match. And it also has sort of a scarf piece that you can place around his neck, do all that kind of stuff. You know, prepare him for the desert. The ghillie suit I mentioned earlier is right here, and you can easily just put that on top, whichever way you want, you know, whenever he's on the ground or something like that. Very nice. I don't know how you would be able to make it sit on top or stay on him, but there's that option. And the pack also gives you a third version of a FMOS. I don't like this sort of handle guard we have here. I do prefer this. I was on the fence on what to use because I couldn't straighten this out with hot water, but it did straighten out, so I'll keep using this. So won't be using this anymore. And this is an extra sort of grenade launcher, which is very nice. So, you know, this one I may use for Dusty. Will I keep the sort of helmet stuff? I don't know. I like the cloth option, but this also looks very good to me, in my opinion. So it's down to preferences. Maybe I'll buy another one and use all this other stuff on that one. But I'll have to wait and see to do that. So yeah, I think that will conclude the review. I'm very excited to have a character. One minor nitpick was the joint that I had, very tight joint. Accessories are great. What else can I mention? I would have liked to see the previous logo we had here, sort of a little palm. I forgot the name of this logo or emblem thing, but it would have been nice to have had that. It would have added a bit more of color to Dusty here. But honestly, that's a very minor nitpick to have. Another thing I was gonna do was say that, you know, at this point you may have other Joes, so you can add a holster and give him his own pistol. So, you know, I may be giving him this sort of Glock pistol from, what is this, Valiverse. So yeah, but other than that, I think this will conclude the video. He's a very nice figure to have, highly recommend him. Of course, there's a lot of bias from my side, but you know, he's just my favorite figure. They announced him, I was excited to get him, and now he's here, and I am as happy as I can be. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed that. You know, we have even a little vintage comparison here, which is always nice to have when it comes to classified now. So yeah, hopefully you all enjoyed today's video. I hope you like, subscribe, and do all that other cool stuff. Leave a comment down below, and I'll see you guys in the next video, where we'll be taking a look at Zarana. You know, she's been peeking her head all video. So next up will be Zarana herself. Thank you all for watching. Have a great day.